Well, I got one on here. I got a stinking chainsaw behind me. I'll try to get the camera pointing at the line. I don't know if you can see that or not, but most important is, I don't know if you can see my fly rod. I got this carp on a 3-weight fly rod. This reel is wonderful. White River, HC2. I'd really like to get a second one of these. I'm on a pretty little sand beach. And we got 1, 2, 3, 4 rods out. It's been a very slow morning. And I've been chumming with canned sweet corn. And you can see the molasses soaked cattle corn that I cooked the hell out of. Got my handmade custom rod holders. So this fish is out. About another 50 yards maybe. Not too bad. I think the line glows more when it's wet. Let's see if you could see the line better that way. Catches the sunlight. This is a disc drag, which is a lot nicer than the Paul drag fly reel I used to use for carp fishing years ago. I got lucky there. It looks like this carp went right over the top of my other line. Seems to be hanging out right above the darn second line here. Okay, we got it. That's my timer to chum again. I was just gonna leave. I was like, oh great, some guy chumming, with a chainsaw. Sounds like he's dropping a dead tree. It's not even a very loud chainsaw, which is nice. Some of them are brutal. But we'll see if it's a hare lip or a rubber lip. This is the first time I fished down this way in a couple of years. You can see my drag starting to go again. Rod's fully bent. 3-weight fly rod. It's a Cortland. It's giving me a workout. As you can see, I use light tackle. Give them the most advantage you could possibly give them. I know it's not a small fish because the way he went out took his time. So it could be one of those type I call a rubber lips. Let's see some swirls out on the water now that every time he turns. Yeah, it looks like a rubber lips. I call a crayfish eater. They do a lot of digging. So you can see my leader now above the surface of the water. Whew, pretty good battle. Yeah, first time he broke the surface. This might be my only fish of the day here. It's been a slow day. But this is the first time I'm chumming this spot, so can't complain. I really thought I was gonna get skunked today. All right, let's see if I can work on this fish without breaking the line. It's a good fish. You don't want to come in right away. I'm trying to bring them up on this sandbar. I'm pretty sure this is the hair rig. It's a double hook that I'm just starting to use recently. Water's about 80 degrees. Tough fish. Tough, tough fish. Come on, you and your big tail. You got a big motor there, buddy? Oh, okay. Come on now. Come to Papa. I'm gonna lay you on your side on the sandbar. Come on. I ain't gonna break my rod. I've done that too many times. I know about that. All right, yeah. It's a decent fish. One of the bigger ones I've caught this year. What I'm gonna do is get my scale, weigh it, measure it, and release it. If I can find my, there it is, my good old South Bend D-Liar that I put a nice big bluefish hook onto. All right, let's do a, it's about a half a pound off. Wow, I got this fish with both hooks. Look at this, pretty cool. And let me get this other one out. By the way, I do use my scale as a disgorger also. I don't want this fish to throw water on my camera lens. Okay, let's see what we got here. Yeah, this fish is a full 8 pounds, maybe 8 and a half, which is as big as I've been getting so far this year. Let's see what it measures out to be. I'm guessing about 25 inches at 8 and a half. That's what it is. Gee whiz, you think I've caught a few of these? Yeah, just about 25 and a quarter or so. Okay, and let's release it, because he deserves some respect. Put it in the sunlight here so maybe you can get a nice view of it. That's a tough fish. Hope you enjoyed that battle as much as I did. Let's see if I can shut the camera off without getting any water in the switch and screwing it all up. But you can see the rods all lined up there. To me, that's heaven. This is all I need to be happy. See you later.